Today, I'm over in Mount Vernon at the WSU Bread Lab Plant Breeding Program. The Bread Lab began in 2011 to conduct research on thousands of lines of wheat, barley, buckwheat, and other small grains to identify those that perform well for farmers and that are most suitable for craft baking, cooking, malting, brewing, and distilling. I'm meeting with their lead field scientist, Steve Lyon, to learn more about the wheat they're testing in the field.
In Eastern Washington, they trial about 60 different varieties all over the state, but they've never sent them over here before.
Oh.
So I can try them, see what works here for farmers. They might work, they might not, but at least if it fails, it's going to fail for me and not the farmer.
Right.
The last thing is we taste it. We bake several of them, and the one that tastes the best is the one that we go with.
Next, I head inside to meet with the director of the Bread Lab, Dr. Steve Jones.
The importance of having a lab embedded within an agricultural community like this, if we can help them discover new varieties that are going to do better for them in terms of yield with fewer inputs, that's going to help their economic situation.
Dr. Jones explained that the Bread Lab consists of a baking kitchen, a cytology lab, the King Arthur Flour Baking School, a milling laboratory, a professional kitchen, and a seed library.
In this room is about 4,000 unique types of wheat and beans. So that wall there has wheats from as far back as the 1500s. There's 1,000 different wheats just on that wall. Thousands of wheats have been lost. Those were all saved, and that's material that we use all the time.
Next on our tour is the mill room, which has numerous mills of all different sizes from around the world.
This is a small-scale model of what milling turned into worldwide in the late 1800s.
Dr. Jones explained that this milling process peels the outer layer of the wheat, leaving the inner layer. However, the outer layer is what holds all the fiber, iron, and zinc.
This is basically starch and gluten.
This has
everything else.
What was the decision-making behind separating it out?
There were a few
like
reasons for it. One was you had to have something that would have a shelf life of forever. And white flour does because, again, it's just starch and gluten.
Because most of the bread found at our local grocery stores is made with white flour, Dr. Jones said their new Bread Lab Collective is working on creating an affordable, approachable, and accessible loaf of bread.
Bakers felt that they're missing a large part of their community, not just from the affordability, but from the approachability or the recognizability of a thing as bread. If we're looking at a baguette or a boule or a batard, all of those are great and they're necessary within our communities. But what's necessary too and what's being missed is that sort of nuts and bolts everyday bread.
Yeah.
As our tour comes to an end, I ask Dr. Jones what he wants the public to know about the Bread Lab.
What's most important to us is, and we take it very seriously, is we're public servants. We work with our community at all levels, not just farmers and millers and bakers and maltsters and brewers and distillers, but eaters.
Yeah.
And that's so important to us, that we're here to serve the greatest part of our community as possible.
Well, I'm glad you're here.
Nice, thank you.